Let's take a look at some of the ways that Shield Illinois school partners are collecting saliva samples to test for COVID-19 without losing much instructional time. First, let's see how one school partner uses a common area, like a gym, for students to provide saliva samples. The teacher hands the student an ID badge with a personal QR code identifier. Once the student reaches the collection area, she sanitizes her hands and receives her test tube and funnel. She proceeds to a designated area, removes her mask, and begins depositing saliva in the tube using the funnel. She taps the side of the tube lightly to settle any bubbles and raises her hand once her saliva reaches the fill line. Once a staff member recognizes her, the student walks to the staff member to verify her saliva sample. Then she discards her funnel in a medical waste bin, screws on the test tube cap, and proceeds to the checkout station. At the checkout station, her QR code is scanned, followed by the label on her test tube in order to associate the test tube with her. She places her test tube in a collection rack, then sanitizes her hands once again and leaves the collection area to return to her classroom. The student is the only person at the collection site who ever touches the test tube to prevent contamination. Including time spent traveling from her classroom to the collection area and back, this student needed less than 5 minutes to provide a sample. Now let's look at a collection model where school personnel bring testing supplies to each classroom on the drool train. A student receives his test tube and funnel from a staff member, then moves to one side of a hallway. After producing enough saliva to fill the vial, a staff member checks his sample and sends him to the checkout station. He removes the funnel and discards it, then places the cap on the test tube. The staff member finds the student's QR code in the binder and scans it, then scans the test tube to associate the two. The student places the test tube in a rack inside a collection tub, sanitizes his hands, and returns to his classroom.